donate or know someone who donates.
Okay, a couple hands.
Well, I want to have everybody raise their hand in this room. So the American Red Cross, it is a disaster relief, blood donating certification. They do all that stuff with this organization. There's about 100 million Americans that they help across the globe. On their website, they have a bunch of personal stories, and I did read through some of them. And I read this one, and there's this lady. Her house went through a natural disaster. There was a flood. So the American Red Cross came in, and they helped with the water. So they pumped out all the water in her house. So now she's able to live there still, so she didn't have to go through moving and everything. There's also another story, husband and wife. She had just had a baby and she needed blood due to problems with her pregnancy. And the blood was from the American Red Cross. I will discuss the problems we face, solutions due to the organization, and outcome of the organization. The American Red Cross was founded in 1881, and it is still providing ways to restore disaster, build communities, and providing life-saving programs and services. Okay, so the problems that we face. The big one would be a natural disaster. So worldwide, 6,700 natural disasters occurred, and that could be from earthquakes, tsunamis, volcanoes, or tornadoes. And with that, we don't know when that happens and we don't know when it can occur, so it can happen anytime. And it claims over 68 lives per year. Another problem is blood deficiency. So 4.5 million Americans will need blood transfusion each year. And a blood transfusion, it's just where you have a blood deficiency, or after a surgery you need more blood because of it. And 1 out of 7 people entering hospital need blood. So you could walk in for a checkup and come out with a whole pint of blood that you didn't even know you needed before. So the first natural disaster, that was according to Relief Web 2016. And the blood deficiency was according to Riley 2007 Community Blood Center. Okay, so now that I've talked about the problems we face, we could talk about how to solve our problems with this organization. So, according to Red Cross 2017, they have overnight shelter stays. So, with that, if your house has been destroyed or you are unable to live in it, they have shelters within that area where you are able to sleep. So, let's say you have a household of four family members. You get to stay in that shelter for 4 nights. They also provide emergency supplies. So within that natural disaster area, if it has hit you or if you're kind of on the streets, they will provide supplies. It's like a little kit. And in that kit, it's all the basic necessities that you don't have at that time, which is like shampoo, deodorant, toothbrush, toothpaste, things like that. It's all in the kit that they hand out. They also have meals and snacks, so they provide hot meals and food if you need it. According to Medical Daily, the blood deficiency, how we solve that problem is to donate blood. Every pint you give can save 3 patients in need of it. Okay, so now that we talked about the solution, this is my chart. So in the first chart, it is a scale of the disasters. So there's 45 multi-million fires that occur, 29 tornadoes, and these are numbers on how much they help out through a year. So there's 6.7 million meals and snacks that are given out. And in the other chart, it is about the blood deficiency. So as I said, 1 pint does save 3 lives. And 3 in 100 Americans donate blood. Okay, so this is the benefits from this organization. Natural disasters. According to Red Cross 2017, It helps cope with family. So if it helps cope with them by mental or physical needs. If you're traumatized from what has happened, there is therapists and support for you there. They also help with the rebuilding process. So volunteers go out and they help build houses for those in need of them. And then according to World Health Organization, blood donations. This, with the blood that has been donated, it could go to women that have complicated pregnancies that need it, children with malnutrition, or even people with complex medical surgeries that are in need of blood. Now that we've talked about the benefits, these are actions you could do. Well, I've talked about the problems we face, solutions that can help from organizations, and the outcome of the organizations. So, American Red Cross was founded in 1881, and they're still providing ways that we can restore disasters, building communities, and providing safe housing. How can you help? You can help by donating your time, your blood, and or your money.